we're back. Folks, just last year, my next guest joined the cast of ABC's long-running police drama, NYPD Blue. Please welcome the lovely Charlotte Ross. How you doing?
Great. I was hoping. I saw that.
Everybody settle down.
I saw that segment with P. Diddy, and I love that red number.
You thought I looked good in the red number? The one where I'm got the tails?
The one where you don't need pants?
Well, what are you trying to tell
me? It was really cute and really subtle, and I thought it looked really good on you.
You thought it looked cute and subtle?
Yeah.
I don't think anything I was wearing looked subtle. But thank you for, let's pretend it did. Yeah, well, thank you for being here.
Thank you for having
me. Congratulations. You're doing well on this show. You enjoy it?
Yeah, I love it. I love it.
This is a very physical role. I mean, when you're on one of these police dramas, I sit here all the time. I could be an accountant.
Oh, really?
But you are, in your job, you're constantly having to beat up people and tackle them. I mean, it's very demanding.
Yeah, I was surprised that I would enjoy the, this sounds so awful, the manhandling part that happens when you play a detective. You have to prove yourself a little bit more when you're a female. And people think because maybe you're petite or blonde that you're not capable. And so I've had to maybe prove myself a little bit more. And I kind of work hard at keeping my physical strength up. I do a lot of Tai Bo.
You do Tai Bo?
Yeah, actually, I've never.
You teach Tai Bo?
Weekends, yeah.
It's funny because I see the commercials. They have those late night commercials.
Yeah.
They're always talking about Tai Bo, and I've never met anybody who actually did Tai Bo.
Yeah,
it's a lot of jumping around.
What is it? Here, I'll show you. Put your hands out like that.
Yeah, yeah, okay.
I mean, I'm not going to do any kicks because I'm wearing a mini skirt, so.
My trick didn't work. All right, right
and
here.
What you do, what the instructors do is they wear mitts
right,
like that.
Right.
And then you keep your body weight kind of low and do a squat and.
Okay, see, they wear mitts. All right, stop that. I'm like, what they do is they wear protective mitts.
Look at you.
But you all just, well, come on. I'm like made of candy.
It's a fun way to work out.
Very delicate, so it mustn't be crushed
or
hurt in any way.
I'm sorry.
What the hell's going on over here?
So
I've noticed that there are some, they have like some celebrities in the video. Like Carmen Electra is in every commercial for Tai Bo. They always show her there and she says like, I love Tai Bo, I'm Carmen Electra. And
then, I didn't know that.
You don't see her in the classes?
No, I see the cast of Scrubs. I see, there's actually a lot of heterosexual men that do this because it's based in karate. It's not like...
Sounds good to me. Heterosexual men? I'll be there in a minute.
Oh my gosh. I used to do a lot of aerobics, you know, leg warmers and that kind of thing. And there weren't that many. So it's a real mixed crowd.
Right, it's a nice mixed crowd. It's a nice place probably to meet people.
Well, I don't know about that, but maybe, I mean, if you want.
No, hey, I'm fine. Now, are you comfortable in your role on TV? You have to carry a gun a lot of the time. And sometimes I can tell actors look uncomfortable that they have to carry a gun. You can just, it's like when people pretend to smoke who don't really smoke.
Well, we have great technical advisors. I think that we would feel kind of left out in the cold if we didn't have a lot of people saying, this is what happens. This is how you hold it. When you, you have to have your elbows straight because they can easily headbutt and all these kind of things. So it makes you feel very confident having all these technical advisors around.
If I was like in a cop drama, whenever I fired the gun, I'd drop it and run away,
you know?
And it would break the tension.
I don't know if that would be a good thing to do if you were a cop, because then they would chase you and they would get you. But you have to be careful you don't, you know, parlay that into real life, because I came home and there were some cops at my house and they thought that they had heard something and...
There was like an alarm went off or something?
An alarm went off and nothing happened. They left and then I heard something and I grabbed a gun and I was walking around the house.
Wait, a real gun or a fake gun?
Well, after the riots, I did get a gun.
Right.
So I have a gun. I know how to use it.
So you have a gun in the house. Well, that's interesting. Not many people...
I do. Well, I'm a single woman in a house and you gotta be careful.
Right.
So anyway, I was walking around the house like I do on the show every day. And I realized, you know...
You were doing all that kind of Charlie's Angels stuff? Then you realized
I was. Wait a minute, this thing is real. You know, this is not make-believe here. You know, you have to be kind of careful.
Right.
Not to get too carried away.
Yes, be very careful with that thing.
I will.
Let me ask you, you did an ad for PETA not too long ago, and it's a stunning ad. It's for a good cause,
yes,
but it's also
a
stunning ad.
Oh,
can we just show this ad for a second? It's just...
thank you. Well, it goes along those lines of subtle, of what we're talking about.
Yeah, that's really,
If it catches your attention even for a couple seconds, it makes you think about how many animals, 30 to 40 sometimes for one coat. That's the whole purpose of the ad. And I've never done nudity
in 2 years. The problem is I kind of like you tune out a little bit on the cause, I gotta say.
Do you?
You know, a little bit, I'm sorry. I'm like, look at that picture. And then you don't, you know, oh yeah, they're PETA.
Then you realize that it's
good.
For PETA, people for the ethical treatment of animals.
Yes, it's a good, no, it's a very good thing.
It's a great
but
cause.
That's a very powerful, you know.
Well, good, it's doing exactly what it's supposed to do then.
Maybe, yes, yes.
Do you have
Are
much
other
fur?
Actors gonna be posing nude in this?
Well,
are we gonna see Ed Asner soon coming out for PETA? Like, how are you?
Oh my gosh.
Check out my butt.
Maybe, you know? Yeah, I'm not sure. I know Chrissy Turlington's done it and Cindy Crawford.
Oh good, they're asking the right people to do this. That's good.
I feel very thankful to be in the company of the people that they've had do it, so.
Now before we go, there's something about, I knew that you had this, you know, this role on the show and that you have this, you've done very well as an actor. I didn't know that you had a gold record. You have a gold record.
Oh, gosh. I did a series a long time ago in 1991 for Aaron Spelling, which was kind of a wannabe cross between 90210 and The Commitments. And we actually got a gold record called "How Do You Talk to an Angel?" We went and
because
sang in the malls.
You sang in malls to promote it.
We sang in the malls, which was very big during the Tiffany era.
Yes, I remember,
that. And I remember.
There's a famous video where Tiffany's like singing. What's the
song?
And
the malls having a full, you know, riot. So what happened is I remember looking out. It was very surreal and thinking, is this really where I want to be? And I saw people going back and forth, and I saw the gap behind all these people. And it was a full mall concert.
You're like, I'm rocking out in front of the Gap.
Yeah, it was the highlight.
This is a great rock and roll moment in front of cargo pants for $19.99.
Exactly, exactly.
In a fine array of colors, too.
I haven't done that a lot lately now. So.
Well, it's a nice thing to have. Not many people have a gold record.
Yeah,
just
no,
you
it
and
was
me
great.
And the people here. The season finale of NYPD Blue airs next Tuesday night at 10 o'clock on ABC.
Yeah.
Congratulations on that. Please come back.
Thank you.
It's nice to have you here.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah. Charlotte Ross, everybody, we'll take a break. We'll be right back. Everybody, that's our show. Do you want to thank my guest, Charlotte Ross? Thank you very much for being here. Very nice to have you on the program. And big thanks to Sean P. Diddy Combs for stopping by and trying to help out my fashion sense. We'd also like to apologize to Dan Natterman. We ran out of time. We'll have him back on the show very soon. He's a very funny comedian, and you must hear this man. And of course, too much funny tonight. And of course, Max Weinberg and the Max Weinberg 7. Stay tuned for Last Call with Carson Daly. We'll see you around. Well, at least you're not bored anymore. Hey, and why should you be? After all, I'm Conan O'Brien, baby. Hop on board, audience, because I'm about to drive this train all the way to Funny Town. What the hell was that sound?
Oh, they didn't tell you, Conan? That's our new jackass gong.
Oh, I guess I did kind of sound like sort of a jackass just now, huh, Max?
Well, that's okay, Conan. I think you're terrific.
Max, I didn't know you felt that way about me. All right, I did know.
I've always loved you, Conan. Almost as much as I love myself.